Good morning, everyone. First of all, I would like to welcome each and every one of you who could make it here and make time for us to join this webinar, especially our today's guest speaker, Mr. Bitamog.
Okay, so our topic for today that that I'm going to elaborate or to discuss and lecture is all about Antonio Pigafetta's first voyage around the world. Okay, so as of the moment, I know that you are fully aware kung sino nga ba si Antonio Pigafetta. And I know yung iba sa inyo hindi rin alam kung sino nga ba siya. Okay. So before we proceed, before I proceed in elaborating the different concepts, the name of the persons who are involved and the persons who have a big role who contributed a lot in the navigation, may I present to you the objectives of our lecture. Okay, so at the end of the lecture, the student should be able to first understand the history of Antonio Pigafetta's first voyage around the world. Second, name the ships they used to circumnavigate the world and classify the driving factors of European exploration. Fourth, summarize the main accomplishment of the first voyage of Pigafetta and Magellan during the time of exploration. Okay, now I need to present the names of the persons who contributed to the success of navigation and exploration of the world. Okay, Pigafetta. So Antonio Pigafetta was born in 1491 and died in 1531. He was an Italian scholar and explorer from the Republic of Venice, and his parents are Giovanni Pigafetta and Angela Soga. He was the eldest child. Okay, then may papadmit. Traveled with the Portuguese explorer Ferdinand Magellan and his crew by the order of King Charles of Spain in their voyage around the world. And we have Ferdinand Magellan. I know that you are fully aware of who is this person. Diba? So kilala naman natin si Ferdinand Magellan. So he was born in February 3, 1480 and died in April 25, 1521. So as you can see, class, he died in our homeland. Tama po ba? He died in? Where did he die? Okay, so I know that during your high school, senior high school years, your high school teacher already discussed kung saan nga ba, kung paano namatay, kung sinong pumatay, at kailan namatay si Ferdinand Magellan. Okay, so moving on. So Portuguese explorer who organized a Spanish expedition to the East Indies from 1519 to the island Spice Island, resulting to the first circumnavigation of Earth completed by Juan Sebastian Elcano. Okay, so Spice Island. So saan nga ba natin matatagpuan itong Spice Island na sinasabi nito? So Spice Island or Maluku Island can be found in Indonesia. So part din po siya ng region ng Southeast Asia. Kung titignan natin sa map natin, eh magkatabilang or kapitbahay natin ang Indonesia. Okay? Well, so by now an experienced seaman, Magellan approached King Manuel of Portugal to seek his support for westward voyage to the Spice Island. The king refused his petition repeatedly in 1517. A frustrated Magellan renounced his Portuguese nationality and relocated to Spain to seek royal support for King Charles, support for his venture, di ba? So, kung titignan natin dito, si Magellan ay humingi ng tulong or suporta coming from King Manuel, but King Manuel declined the support or declined the petition of Magellan. That is why Magellan decided to renounce his Portuguese nationality, and he opted or he tend to or decided to, I should say, decided to move and migrate to Spain because he firmly believed that the King of Spain will sponsor his voyage to explore the east or the explore the world. Okay, now Let's see. So King Charles, he was only 18 years old during that time. And King Charles granted his support to Magellan, who in turn promised the young king that his westward sea voyage would bring immeasurable riches to Spain. Okay. So, ang ginawa niya, nag-seek siya ng alliance. Lang, ayusin lang natin. Nag-seek siya ng alliance to Spain through King Charles I. Tama po ba? Ngayon, ang sabi niya, sponsoran mo, suportahan mo ako at bibigyan kita, pagbalik ko, bibigyan kita or bibigyan kita ng mas marami pang kayamanan ng ginto, pilak, resources, and so on and so forth. Okay, so since King Charles was too young during that time, and of course, they are after glory, they are after fame. That is why they decided to accept the petition of what we call Ferdinand Magellan or his request to travel around the world and to explore the natural resources. Okay? Then, pag-aaralan din natin mamaya or malalaman natin kung bakit nga meron tayong tinatawag na westward and eastward Portugal. Okay, so that is related, interconnected to what we are talking about, to what they call as Treaty of Tordesillas. We will elaborate it later on. Okay, so the age of exploration, also the age of discovery. Yes, it, diba? So mag-explore ka. So I think exploration and discovery, parang same din lang eh, diba? How can you explore if you will not discover? Diba? So it began in 1400s and continued throughout the 1600s. It was a period of time when the European nation began exploring the world. But what are the hindrances kung bakit nga ba itong mga European eh medyo takot sila na maglayag or mag-explore ng different routes sa ibang different routes para makarating sa ibang lugar to discover or to explore their resources? Bakit? There are some hindrances, just like for instance, takot kasi sila sa tinatawag nating na sea monster. They have this perception before na itong ocean daw ay mayroong mga sea monster na kumakahin ng ship, mga tao. Then apart from that, takot din sila that baka kasi yung paniniwala nila na ocean daw ay meron siyang end. Diba? Kung nakikita ninyo dito sa larawan class, based on the picture, naniniwala sila na parang ito na yung end or tip ng ocean. Kapag sila nakalulan ng bangka or sasakyang pandagat, mahuhulog yan. That is why they do not tend to use another road. Pero meron isang tao na naglakas na mag-explore or mag-discover ng new roads patungo sa ibang bansa to explore natural resources. Okay, siya si Ferdinand Magellan. Okay, now we have this what we call Treaty of Tordesillas. Diba? So the Treaty of Tordesillas was signed in Tordesillas, Spain on June 7, authenticated in Setúbal. So kung titignan natin, ang Spain at Portugal, dikit lamang sila. Tama po ba? Okay, so they divided the newly discovered lands outside Europe between the Portuguese Empire and the Spanish Empire along Mediterranean 360 leagues west of the Cape, the islands of the west coast of Africa. So, always keep in mind na ang westward daw ay explore. While the eastward, ito ang gagamitin ng mga Portuguese. So, hinati nila ang earth, westward and eastward. So kaari ng Spain, east naman pag-aari ng Portugal. That is why, if you can still remember, Magellan used the westward to explore or circumnavigate. Diba? Yun po ang kanyang ginamit kasi nga he seeks alliance to the king and queen of Spain. Okay. Now, what are the main reasons of exploration? Bakit nga ba? Why is it that exploration is important nowadays? First, we have, if you can still remember, economy is the major motive factor in the European age of was the search for direct access to rapid eastern spice trade. So, kung babalikan Magellan at si Antonio Pigafetta or these Spaniards navigators decided to explore or to explore and discover new places because they are after spices. These spices will be used to preserve their foods. Tama po ba? Kasi ang nangyayari, ang mga pagkain nila ay madaling mapanis. It easily spoiled. Tama po ba? That is why they decided to seek or explore and discover new spices that they can use to preserve their foods. Diba? Yung mga pagkain nila. Then apart from that, they also use that to make their food more tastier. Then they also use this for medicine. Yung herbal natin. Ugat ng mga kahoy na kanilang na-discover before that they prove na nakakagamot sa mga illnesses ng mga tao during that time. Because if you can still remember, European, according to history, European people during that time, hindi pa ganun ka-hygienic. Tama po ba? Hindi sila ganun ka-hygienic if you're going back to our history. Then, they also use the silk. Ferdinand Magellan, matatagpuan yun sa China. Pero bakit nga ba? Yun, let's continue. So next, we have this what we call political. So what is political? So in the 15th century class, Europe sought to expand trade routes to find new source of wealth and any newly found lands. Okay. So why is it that they are exploiting and even subjugating these colonies, these people who lives in a certain colonies or areas? Because they firmly believe na kapag na-colonize nila, na-subjugate nila, yung isang lugar, mas direkta nilang makukuha yung mga resources. That is one of their main reasons why is it they are exploring or they are colonizing. Then this European age of discovery saw the rise of colonial empires on a global scale, building a commercial network that connected Europe, Asia, Africa, and the New World. Okay, so that is political. Okay, so as of the moment, even in our current times, di ba, as you can see, there are still nations who conquer other lands because they seek their resources, oil, and so on and so forth. So history repeat itself. Sabi nga nila, parang pinagpapatuloy lang natin ang ating kasaysayan. Okay, next, we have this religious. In religious, Spanish missionaries carried Catholicism to the New World and the Philippines establishing various missions in the newly colonized land. The mission served as a base for both administering colonies as well as spreading Christianity. Yes. Diba? One of their objectives then is to spread Christianity. And Magellan is the one who spread the Christianity in Mactan. He started in Mactan and Humonhon, diba? Then, kung babalikan din natin class, students, dear students, ano nga ba yung ginawa nila sa ating mga Pilipino? Parang, since na-spread na yung Catholicism, parang in my own perception and historians sa atin, tapos in return, ibinigay natin yung lupain natin sa kanila. Diba? So, in terms of religion. And we cannot deny the fact that Filipinos during that time is gullible. Madali lang po silang mauto. Kaya madaling na-spread ang Christianity at na madaling napasakamay ng Espanya ang Pilipinas during that time. Okay, now we have these three G's. What are these three G's? We have this what we call, in terms of God kasi, di ba three G's, yung sa mga explorers na to, navigators, we have this God, gold, and glory. In God, we have this Catholicism and Protestantism. Protestants, Catholic, and Protestants. Always keep in mind that Catholics during that time believe that salvation to eternal life is God's will for all the people. You must believe Jesus was the Son of God and receive baptism. Confess your sin and take part in a holy mass obtain. While in Protestants believes that salvation to eternal life in God's will for all people. Okay, so yun po, in terms of God in three G's, they spread faith, they spread Christianity to easily subjugate the people. Second is gold. Why is gold important or to be included in three G's? Because gold, it refers to the search for wealth through buying and selling Asian spices. So ginagamit po ang gold nito to buy spices, to buy resources, di ba? Parang ginawang trading mark po or trading material to buy goods and services coming from different nationalities. So ginagamit din ang ginto to buy African slaves. That is why maraming mga, di ba, yung tinatawag natin, there are a lot of African Americans, African British, di ba, Australian Nigerians or Australian Africans, because they all came from Africa. They all started from being a slave. Then American metals and other resources. So that is the purpose of gold. While glory is individual explorers competent for fame and honor for both themselves and their countries. Diba? Ang sinasabi nila, the bigger your territory, the higher the authority you have. So, kapag mas malawak ang iyong teritoryo, mas malakas ang iyong bansa, at mas ikaw ay kilala, mas sikat ka, di ba? Kasi yun yung paniniwala nila that in terms of land or in terms of property, if you have a wide vast of land or territory, fellow explorers will tend to magkakaroon ng preconceived notion na sasabihin na ang lakas naman pala nila, di ba? So that is why 3Gs is interrelated or part of this navigation and exploration. Okay. Then apart from that, always keep in mind that Magellan and Pigafetta are both contemporary at same time. So nangyari ito sa parehas nilang kapanahunan. That is why they are both contemporary. So imagine if Pigafetta was not present during that voyage. Kung wala si Pigafetta, wala yung pinagkaraan. So, on September 2019, Magellan set sail from Spain in an effort to find a Western Sea Route. Yes, they use Western Sea Route because they came from Spain. Because they need to adhere to the Treaty of Tordesillas, kung saan ito yung pinag-agree ang country of Portugal and Spain during that time, back in 1400s. Then, road to the rich spice islands of Indonesia. That is their main objective, to find the spice island of Indonesia. However, hindi nila natagpuan ang Spice Island, kundi... Okay. So, in command of 5 ships and 270 men, Magellan sailed to West Africa and then to Brazil, where he searched the South American coast for a strait that would take him to the Pacific. Okay, so the fleet under Ferdinand Magellan sailed across the Atlantic Ocean to South Africa, to South America, I should say, and Rio de Janeiro. So Rio de Janeiro is part of Brazil. Then Magellan then started to search for a passage to the Pacific Ocean. Okay, so then on November 21, 1520, Ferdinand Magellan entered the strait which would be forever named in his honor, the Magellan Strait. They were to be the first European ever to sail across the Pacific, the names Pacific. You know what? That it took 38 days for Ferdinand Magellan to cross the Magellan Strait in South America. 38 days po yan. And after 38 days, nakarating na sila sa Pacific Ocean. And it took them at least 98 days, if I'm not mistaken, bago nila nakarating ang isla ng Guam. Okay. Now, before we move on, before we continue, these are the 5 ships that they use in expedition and the names of the commander in each ship. The Magellan commanded the Trinidad. Okay, so yun po yung boat or yung ship na kinomand ni Magellan. Then Juan de Cartega commanded the San Antonio. Then Gaspar de Casada commanded Concepcion. And Luis de Mendoza was fully aware that Victoria was the only one or the only ship that were able to return back to Spain during that time. And we have also Juan Serrano commanded the Santiago. So a total of 270 crew. Okay. Now, in 1519, they started their voyage to explore the world using the westward direction for Spain and east ward for Portugal as they agreed in Treaty of Tordesillas. So kung dito sa left side, gagamitin nila internet connection. Okay. So in westward, it was used by Spaniards and the eastward used by Portugal. Okay. So that is why medyo natagalan sila because of course they are seeking for new exploration and for new discovery. Okay, moving on. In March 1521, they landed on Guam. So, 500 AD, Camoro people of Guam, Malay origin migrated to Guam. 1521, Ferdinand Magellan of Portugal called it Isla de Ladrones or Island of Thieves. Bakit nga ba? Kasi ang nangyari, class, itong mga crew niya, binigyan or sabihin na lang natin na binigyan ng pagkain nitong mga Malays, ng mga tao sa Islas de Ladrones. Pero not knowing na ang ginawa ng mga tao or ng mga Malay origins na to, inuhan nila yung mga kagamitan ng kanilang barko. So, minakita. So, that's why as the land. Because islanders took whatever they could from his ship as payment for the food and water they had given the crew. Okay. So, moving on. So, at first sight of Samal, so nakarating na sila sa Samal, they were afraid having an unpleasant experience just 10 days before. Of course, meron na silang trauma na saan these people from Island de Ladrones still and took their at daybreak on March 16, 1521, Spain pursued what couldn't like hope on the horizon and the islands of Samal. Now summer shimmered in the eyes of of Portuguese, Explorer Ferdinand Magellan and his crew. Okay, so after 10 days of then after that, Magellan and his crew drop anchor of the inhabited Homonhon Island, then known as Humumu, on March 16, 1521, where they stayed for 8 days before proceeding with their journey to what is now known as Philippines. Then on March 29, 1521, or 2 days before the iconic scene of the Eastern Sunday Mass, the Kasikasi, was conducted between the traveler Magellan and Haha Kulambo, King of Limasawa and Kasikasi, meant blood signifying brotherhood. Okay. Gracious Mila. Okay. So on March 15, 29, 1521, nagkaroon ng blood compact between Magellan and Raja Colombo and Raja Humabon during that time. In what? In return of? Okay. So, tinanggap nila Raja Humabon at Raja Colombo, sina Magellan and even his crew, para gamitin siya. Sabihin na lang natin na gamitin siya to talk to Lapu-Lapu who they considered as traitor during that time. Diba? Kasi ugali naman ng Pilipino yan eh. Yung sinasabi nila na traitors daw. Okay, so let's see. Then, on April 7, 1521, Raja Humabon, his wife, and hundreds of his native warriors agreed to accept Christianity and were consequently they agreed to be baptized as Christians in return of what? As long as they will talk or Magellan will talk to Lapu-Lapu and convince Lapu-Lapu to agree to the terms of Raja Humabon. But you know what happened? Hindi umagree si Lapu-Lapu. So that is why yun na, nagkaroon ng digmaan. But before that, Magellan planted a cross to signify this important event about the propagation of the Roman Catholic faith in what is now Cebu, in central Philippines. So that is why they conducted the first Catholic Mass or Christian Mass sa Limasawa Island, just like that. Pero yung iba, nasabi nila that it started or the first mass was conducted in Cebu. Okay. The original cross is reputedly encased in another wooden cross for protection as people started chipping it away and believed that it had miraculous healing powers. Diba? If you can still remember, na itong mga raha natin, itong mga raha nila, even some Filipinos are pagan during that time. Yung sinasamba, di ba? May mga ani-anito, sinasamba nila yung tubig, sinasamba nila yung bato. But since Christianity came, nag-convert sila into Christianity and they accepted Jesus Christ as their Savior. Okay, so ang isa sa mga tumulong para may patayo itong cross ay ang mga tao or native Filipinos din lang during that time because they believe that once they standed or baptized and converted, sabihin na lang natin, converted into Christianity, mas yung miraculo, they believe na merong miracles na mangyayari sa kanila. Okay. Then they already eradicated and abolished their beliefs about paganism, about ani-anito during that time. Okay, so Raja Humabon and Datu Sula suggest that Magellan go to the island of Mactan and force his subject shifting Datu Lapu-Lapu to comply with his orders. Magellan saw an opportunity to strengthen the existing friendship ties with the ruler of Visaya region and agreed to help him subdue the rebellious Lapu-Lapu. Okay, so yun po yung nangyari na kung saan Raho Mabon and Dato Sula and Raho Colombo convinced Magellan to talk to Lapu-Lapu to subdue the rebellion, sabihin na lang natin. Pero what happened? It did not succeed. Why? Because ayaw ni Lapu-Lapu na merong nagdidikta sa during the time. Because of course, he was a leader during the time. Or the fight started between Magellan and Lapu-Lapu. So in April 27, 1521, the warriors of Lapu-Lapu, one of the datos of Mactan, overpowered and defeated a Spanish force. Force lightning for Rahaw Mabon of Cebu under the command of Portuguese Magellan, who was killed in the battle. Okay, so you know what, plus additional information is that yung mga kasama kasi ni Ferdinand Magellan ay tumakbo, natakot sila. So instead of fighting, nung nakita na nila itong mga native or mga native warriors, native Filipino na kasama ni Lapu-Lapu during that time, natakot sila. Kaya bakit sila natakot? Because they saw na itong mga native Filipinos ay punong-puno sila ng mga tattoo sa mga katawan nila. We call it nowadays as pintados, di ba? Kasi during that time, they had this ritual na kapag mas maraming tattoo ang isang tao, mas yung kanyang social stratification at yung kagalingan niya sa pakikidigma ay mataas. Sabihin na lang natin na meron na siyang it serves as a promotion for them if you have a lot of tattoo. Okay. So, you know what? Only 15 men stayed with Magellan and fighting hundreds of native Filipino during that time. And yun nga, paano nga ba namatay si Ferdinand Magellan? They killed Ferdinand Magellan using an arrow. Na tong arrow na to ay meron daw po siyang poison. Then after that, natamaan yung kanyang paa. Nung natamaan na yung kanyang paa, of course, nanghina na siya. Then they grabbed they take an advantage to what? To stab him at or patayin siya. Okay, so in September 6, 1522, and wait lang pala, may additional. So after that, of course, 15 lang yung katao ni Ferdinand Magellan, yung iba kasi nagtakbuhan, katulad ni Antonio Pigafetta and yung mga kasama na Sebastian Elcano, they are the ones who ran away. Pero you know what, ang sabi according to history, talagang inassure pa ni Ferdinand Magellan na makabalik sa ship nila itong mga crew niya bago, sabihin na lang natin, malagutan ng hininga during that time. Okay. So in September 6, nakarating sila or nakabalik na sila sa Spain noong September 6 with only 18 or 19 survivors, lulan ng barkong Victoria at what we call this, La Trinidad, if I'm not mistaken. Okay. So bakit nga ba? Actually, yung sa Victoria, konti lang yung crew na natira doon. Mga nasa 18 lang siya. Pero itong 18, nadagdagan pa, nasa 25 ata. Bakit? Kasi yung dalawang ship yan yung natira. Yung isa kasi, dumiretso siya using the route of India. Tapos yung isa naman, bumalik ulit using the road papunta sa Portugal. Ngayon, syempre, merong hidwaan or may agreement itong Spain at Portugal. Kaya naman, na-capture itong Portuguese country or itong Portugal, itong crew ng isang barko. Kaya ang ginawa nila, in-imprison nila or nilagay nila sa kulungan yung mga na-capture nilang mga Spain during that time. So, yun na, class. Nakabalik sina Sebastian Elcano at si Antonio Pigafetta. Okay. So, what is the significance of circumnavigation and exploration of Pigafetta? Okay, so kung wala si Antonio Pigafetta, hindi natin mapag-aaralan or wala tayong history about the what happened to Magellan and to the circumnavigation of the world. And we also prove na itong mundo ay hindi siya platen, kundi oblique siya or bilog siya. Okay, so na-eradicate na or na-abolish niya yung theory that is platen. Okay, yun po yung significance ng history ito. At after that, napalakas na rin ang navigation ng Spain during that time through Prince Henry, kasi during that time after that, naging naval superior na ang Spain. Okay. So that is the history of naval exploration or circumnavigation Antonio Pigafetta. So I'm so sorry, ang dami ko pa sa gustong i-discuss pero limited time lang. So again, yung summary or at least konting information about what happened during the circumnavigation of Magellan and Antonio Pigafetta. So thank you. So that's the my discussion.
Yes, sir. It was a very important
lecture, I should say. Thank you. Thank you so much. Go ahead. Take over, Ms. Danielle and...
Yes, sir. Thank you so much again, Mr. Bitamog.
I am Sean Ison, the leader of this group, and it is indeed my pleasure to make a few closing remarks and express my gratitude to all those who made this webinar a reality. Thank you very much to each and every one of you for attending this webinar. Our hard works and sacrifices has come to an end, and I'm sure whatever the results we get from this webinar will be appreciated and a good one. Lastly, to our Almighty God, who always showers us with blessings, as we can all see in this webinar. Again, thank you very much and have a good day.